I'm Alisa Parenti at Bloomberg. We are joined by Sarah Holden with the Investment Company Institute. We've got a look at what taxpayers should be focused on down the wire here, Sarah.
Well, tax time is the perfect time to think about opening an IRA or contributing to one if you already have one. There's already 44 million U.S. households have about $9 trillion saved in IRAs. And if you haven't already joined them, you might want to consider opening one because you may actually be able to reduce your taxable income for last year.
You know, this is such an important piece. People don't realize when you think about cutting your taxes and different things you can do, this is something I think that goes unnoticed. Is that the case, do you think?
Yeah, I think because it's a sort of a unique feature of the IRA that you can actually contribute up until tax day and have it count as having occurred last year. And so if you're able to make a deductible contribution to a traditional IRA, you would actually be able to reduce your taxable income, which would reduce your tax bill.
What other suggestions do you have for people at this time?
Well, at this time, really, the thing to do is research whether you can contribute to an IRA. You have two choices there. There's the traditional IRA and the Roth IRA. With the traditional IRA, you may be able to make a deductible contribution. If not, you can typically make an after-tax contribution. Once the money goes into that IRA, it grows inside the account, and you don't pay taxes on all those reinvested dividends and earnings. So it's a great tax deal while you have the money in the IRA. And then with the traditional, when you reach retirement and you start taking the money out, you do pay taxes as it counts as part of your income then. Now, your other option would be to look to see whether you could do what's called a Roth IRA. And with a Roth IRA, it's after-tax money going in, so it won't impact your tax bill this year, but it will reduce your tax bill in years to come because, again, when the money is inside the IRA, it continues to grow and compound without you paying taxes on those earnings. And with the Roth in retirement, when you take the money out, it comes out tax-free because you paid the taxes up front.
It's interesting because, Sarah, I have a good friend who recently retired, and she was talking about how happy she was that she had gone that route. And I think people earlier in their careers are not mindful of this, that if you pay the taxes on it now, yes, it might be a one-time, it might be a hit earlier on, but that boy, what a benefit down the road.
Yeah, so for each individual, what you want to think about is what's your tax rate now versus what your tax rate will be in retirement. So we find many younger folks who are early in their careers like doing the Roth now because they're in a low tax bracket, and then they'll be able to take the money out tax-free in retirement. The other thing to think about with the Roth versus the traditional is with the traditional, you must start taking the money out each year once you hit 70 and a half, and so that's sort of even small payments coming out. With the Roth, there is no such requirement for you to start taking the money. And because you don't pay taxes on it as it comes out, if you were to have a big expense, like, you know, you needed to fix your roof, you could take the money out of the Roth IRA and it wouldn't impact your tax bill. So it gives you nice flexibility. And between the two options, people can think about, you know, timing of their taxes.
Are there any other points that you wanted to bring up?
Just that it's really easy to open up an IRA. If you're a do-it-yourself type person, you could go online and look up the rules on the IRS website. You could go online to a mutual fund company or a discount broker and just set it up yourself. If you're someone who'd like a little bit more help, you could call a phone center rep and talk to them, and they could walk you through the process of opening up the IRA. Or if you already have a financial advisor that you're working with, they could help you as well. So many, many, many options and many, many places to open up an IRA, and it's a really powerful tool.
Thank you to Sarah Holden with the Investment Company Institute. I'm Alisa Parenti at Bloomberg.